website is thelibertyman.com, John Moore, thelibertyman.com. And Ann Morrison, our scientist, space weather, earth changes, sinkholes, viral, if you want to call it, releases, all the other things that need to be dealt with. Ann's website is
homeland-defense4u.com.
defense4u.com. Now, John, you have some very shocking news, and probably that's why I dropped this statement on your website. What you just said before the show, literally a minute ago, it's your stage. You got to tell us what's happening right now.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Dr. Bill. I just got a report from a confidential source that DHS representatives, agents, are showing up at some of these Walmarts when the semi-tractor trailer arrives to unload ammunition for the Walmart store, and they're taking control of the ammunition and removing it from the premises. That's what I was just told less than an hour ago.
I need to
protect my source because it's an ongoing investigation. We're hoping to get video of the next seizure of this ammunition and be able to go public with it. So I got to withhold the location of the one.
What about which is in the east or west coast?
It's west Mississippi.
Well, okay. Now, realistically, if you look at the history of the rise of the Soviet Union, China, and any country that grabs your guns, there's always a genocide of the citizenry afterward because we're going to call it, they call it, democracide, if you want to call it. It was democracy, but it would be the same thing with the Soviet Union or Cambodia. Every time a government grabs guns, they're going to kill their citizens. So the fact that they're doing this means that they're about to collapse the current economic order, or they know there's an extinction-level type event coming, and they want total control before the event happens so that they don't lose control, that we interfere with their survival. That's what's going on. They're also grabbing everybody's assets, because the very fact that they're putting 0% on the money in the banks means they're stealing at least 5 to 10% of your money each year, which includes inflation, plus the fact there's no money given when you put your money in the banks. And now they're calling your money an investment in the banks. So if the bank's going insolvent, they won't just ask the government for a bailout. They're going to bail in by grabbing your money, which means deposits. If the FDIC, which is...
deposits anymore. You're an investor. That's why they can take it, because you're not a depositor anymore. You're an investor.
Right. Now, that's obscene. There was no... the old idea of a contract is you have to make sure both parties agree to the terms of the contract. But governments are unethical. And when the gloves are off and they're being this bad, it means we're really close to something catastrophic. And I believe, as Professor McKenney says, that catastrophic thing is an extinction-level event that's out of the control of the globalist elite. And they're in a panic to try to get things done before these events happen, because they can't wait and participate in trying to take control when the disaster strikes, because they'll basically be stymied and paralyzed by the same events. No power, no control. No power grid, no control. And we'll have 2,000 city-states plus around the world, and there'll be a boss of each city either run by civilian militia or gangs or an amalgamation. The idea that the military is going to be even part of the equation is just stupid, because there's not enough military on the planet to control all the citizenry of 7-plus billion people. It's not possible. Especially in a big country like America. You might control a little nation like Luxembourg, but trying to control America, even if you import the entire Chinese and North Korean army in here, they'll just be like throwing raw meat into a hamburger machine, to turn them into, to kill them. Especially with the tactics that we can, as Americans, know. And the idea that they're going to, stop a shipment of bullets at Walmart and somehow that's going to stop Americans, all it's going to do is inflame them. In fact, I used a joke a few weeks ago that we should have a new t-shirt made. If there's anybody out there selling small little bullet companies now, they're going to make their own private bullets, sell them on the open market, or they're selling guns before, in their particular state where it's still allowed. They need to make t-shirts with Obama with a cigarette hanging out of his mouth, and the t-shirt says, "Do you like me now?" And on the t-shirt, it shows Obama carrying an AK-47 with a 45-round magazine. Because it really is crazy. I mean, when you look at this, anybody who even thinks that they want to argue with the whining, controlling freak people, what about Newton, Connecticut? Newton, Connecticut, that kid should have been in a psychiatric facility. You take the kids away from the gun, not the guns from the kids. That kid should have had multiple people that were responsible, from the school nurse to the teacher to the parent to anybody else, his pastor, anybody else involved, and he shouldn't have had a prolonged process. It should have been like 5 minutes. If I saw that kid coming to my medical office, I would have called the police, had him zip-tied, and have him hauled out of there immediately in a posy jacket all the way to a psychiatric facility where he'd be remanded for a full investigation, and he wouldn't be coming out. He'd be in a lockdown facility with no day passes.
Well, actually, the evidence came out today, Doctor, that the psychologist at the university pretty much did what you just suggested. Not all the way, but she did contact the campus police and notify them that she thought this man was dangerous.
You know, why didn't they do something? They got to follow through. I followed through. When I see people who are crazy, I had people...
They deactivated his college ID. They deactivated his magnetic cards is all they did.
Yeah, right. Okay. What we have is, there's no substitute for irresponsible citizens not taking their part. For example, if you're in an area of the country where there's criminals that can have guns, and you're a 77-year-old female who's a crack shot because you go to the gun range every week, and you got two in your purse and you're a crack shot, and some guy tries to rob the bank where you just happen to be going to the teller, and you take out your gun, which, by the way, happened a few years ago in Detroit, and the 77-year-old lady took five of these criminals trying to rob the bank with guns and shotguns and everything and put them on the ground dead. And when,
good for her.
That's the place to go. Not to a detention center, not to a psychiatric facility, to the grave. And what she did is she was acting for as a secretary for Jesus. She didn't judge them. She just arranged an appointment to meet Jesus.
Absolutely, and that was a good thing.
Yeah, so now she was putting on her secretary hat. She said, "You're going to meet Jesus now."
Well, we need more people like that, and less people like these governors signing these laws.
Well, and compromising. First off, I've talked to the guys, and I read off the letters here before the show, talking about Gun Owners of America. And the fact is, a registry won't work, first off, because people are crazy like Adam Lanza, number one. There's only a few hundred names in the system. And you need to have it go both ways. You don't want a vet coming back and because they have a transitory depression permanently being put on a list so they can never get a gun. Or they have PTSD and they get treatment and they're better. You don't want to have a situation where anybody in anywhere can put you on the list. You know, you piss off some politician and they put you on a list. You piss off your pastor.
Exactly.
You say something in a tweet and all of a sudden you're on a list. What we need to do is have a more responsible system that I believe goes back to the county sheriff. I think if you want to buy a gun or a private sale, it should go through the county sheriff. And I think
Absolutely.
It should never be available to the state. It never should be available to the federal government. And we don't need a parallel set of federalized agencies like federalized police officers, which they're doing with a number of cities. Like Detroit, we have, in a sense, federalized police officers running the place.
Well, I agree.
Yeah.
Speaking of Gun Owners of America, I'm having dinner with Larry Pratt in about 2 hours with Gun Owners of America. I'll tell him
That's great. Yeah, he'll be on the show. I think he's on next week, actually. But what final statements would you say, John, because you're an expert on the earth changes and the other things, and I think we're really close to some very catastrophic things. We're going to see a meltdown in the bond market.
Various, you know, researchers like myself and Professor McKinney, we've known for many years that as we got closer to the main event, these other events, the volcanism, the seismic activity, the bizarre weather, would become more frequent and more severe in all categories. That's exactly
right.
What we're seeing. That is exactly what we're seeing.
And by the way, that causes famine. So it's literally like the ancient prophecies of Joseph. Remember, every prophecy in the Bible has a four prophetic revelation or exposure and a ladder. So the latter day of the Josephine prophecies, which are the seven fat and lean years, the fat years are over. 2013 is the start of the lean years, which means we are technically in a worldwide famine right now. People don't know that, but we are. In fact, the Arab Spring was a direct result of the famine, catalyzed by two things: climate change caused by these global catastrophic things, and speculation by bankers and derivatives who were bailed out and used the bailout money.
We got a break, and I got to get back to a meeting. Well, let's turn it over to Ann at this point.
Amazing. Thank you, John. Again, listen to John's show, thelibertyman.com, 7 to 9 a.m., Monday to Friday, CST. Back in a moment with Ann Morrison, her report. Joining us also, Alexander Bachman. Welcome back, and Ann Morrison, we're joined with Alexander Bachman, and give us the latest reports of what's going on in space weather, earth changes, viruses, all the other scientific areas that you research. What have you found?
Well, I want to remind people that there will be a comet entering the solar system, and it is visible on or about the middle of this month, April 18th, in the northern hemisphere. It's already visible.
That's the Lemon Comet, right? Lemon Comet, right?
Lemon Comet.
And now, how big is that Lemon Comet? Is it big enough to have any gravitonic effects or plasma effects on the Earth or its weather systems? Remember, interaction with the plasma of the comet and the plasma of our ionosphere can change climate, can cause superstorms, and can cause geotectonic events. And as it passes close enough to the sun, it can produce superstorms in the sun that can hit us indirectly.
Well, this comet is on an elliptical orbit, and it comes by every 11,000 years. So you probably wonder why they call it 2012 F6. Well, that's because they discovered it in 2012, and it was the sixth one that was observed at the Lemon Observatory in Arizona. And they plotted the orbit, and they realized that this comet had an elliptical orbit, and that they measured the size of the orbit, and they said, oh, it comes by every 11,000 years or so.
Right. Wow. Anything else about sinkholes, volcanism?
Induced, but we do have folk tales and anecdotal evidence that when this comet passes through our solar system, there could be something significant happen, yes.
Yeah, this one, the first one passed near the orbit of Mercury, which is a very inner solar system. This one actually passes between Earth and Venus, which is pretty damn close to our pathway. So you wonder if it's going to cause gravitonic or geotectonic events to happen, which could trigger off superquakes, etc. We already know that the climate shift and the movement of the jet stream, which is further disrupted by the Macondo, which is the devil's food, that's the actual word Macondo in African, what it means, at the Gulf of Mexico, that's still leaking, and they're still using Corexit 9500 at the ocean floor, not the surface, to make sure people don't see the oil, so tourism still is going on, even though the shrimp are being born without eyes, and the fish have got multiple sores and tumors on them. No, they don't want you to believe that. They want you to come on down, and barbecue.
Not only that, you can buy Gulf shrimp in the supermarkets again, frozen
right,
Gulf shrimp.
Yeah, well, the same thing that they're shipping all the radioactive food all over Japan. And by the way, you got a report you sent me, which corroborates what I've been receiving from other sources, Alexander, right in Yahoo News now, about Fukushima fault may be causing illness in American babies, and they're talking about permanent congenital inborn hypothyroidism. The actual rate, and this is from my own sources, is 300 to 400% increase in thyroid nodules and tumors in children, and a 400 to 600% increase in thyroid cancer in children and adults. In fact, one of my close friends is going in for surgery in the next week because of a thyroid cancer, probably triggered off by Fukushima Daiichi.
Well, there we go. Now all the children 2 years of and under are going to be affected, and this finally hit the mainstream because, I mean, we've been talking about Fukushima for the, what, last 2 years? And the mainstream picks up the story. Well, now a study says that Fukushima fallout, nuclear fallout, is causing illnesses in American babies. And just quickly, that you know, the effects of when we talk about hypothyroidism on infants, children,
cretinism,
mental retardation, and stunted growth,
3 to 5 points.
Among other things,
3 to 5 points loss in IQ per month in the first year. And by the way, cretinism in utero causes a microcephaly or small brain. The treatment for it is for the pregnant mothers to be taking Neutrodyne right now, Mitothyroid, and Selenium cruciferate now. And every adult should be taking this urgently, and every person should be taking it. We had tremendous sales with the 7 for Heaven sale, which God gave me an inspiration to use that title. But you need to spread the word. If you're not taking Neutrodyne, which is diatomic Edgar Cayce prophetic iodine, not just the northern hemisphere, by the way. This radiation level is being detected in Australia. It's being detected in the air currents around the world because they cross the equator. And now every ocean on Earth is radioactive, every single one. Some are more than less than others, but it's everywhere. So this idea you're going to avoid
dying.
It.
You know, we got the sea pups dying off this Southern California coast. Now we have, on the West Coast, this study says all the babies that are 2 years older are going to be affected. They're already affected. We got blanketed by the plutonium and uranium. That's the truth. We got blanketed.
Right. And by the way, a lot of these are three fresh isotopes. I mentioned in the first hour, the second hour, the three different ways that radioisotopes are created: hydrovolcanic activity, zirconium-related production of hydrogens, hydrogen explosions, and criticality occurring because you're like a lava lamp with criticality occurring, releasing cesium-134 and strontium-90 and other isotopes are short-acting like iodine-131. So this is the worst environmental disaster in history, to follow the second worst, which is a Macondo. And it says, and I saw the bitterness, the Chernobyl is the Russian term, that one-third of the creatures in the oceans will die. And by the way, I just read a report today from San Diego about all the seal pups showing up along the beaches here, literally within 10, 20 miles from here, along the beaches of Southern California. And a lot of them are attributed to all kinds of other illnesses. But then at the bottom of the list, radioactivity. Well, when you're exposed to a lot of radioactivity, yes, you'll succumb to pathogens. Yes, you'll succumb if you're...
And then ding, ding, ding for you, Dr. Deagle. Remember you said it's going to mutate. It's going to mutate. And it's going to start jumping into humans. Well, this today on the Japan Times website. This is mainstream. Right. China bird flu mutates and might infect mammals, including humans.
Right. Now, when you expose human beings, this is research going back to the 1960s in New Orleans at the Cyclotron Research Center for American Bioweapons Research. They discovered if you take an animal exposed with a virus and you irradiate them, you take a virus that's not pathogenic and you make it into a super continent killer. The fact is, all these millions of people exposed with their immune systems wiped out and they're under incredible free radical stress, that stress translates to the virus and the virus mutates. And you make it become ultra-pathogenic. So it's my prediction that Japan and Asia and China, by the way, will be the emerging thing, which is why even though they spent $5 million to remove it from the movie World War Z, we are on the front edge of an airborne, mankind-killing super plague. And the government wants to make the best hay out of this, which is why they want to grab our guns and get the cashless society in place and tracker chips either implanted in us or a tag on us. But they don't want anybody to have cash in their pocket. They don't want anybody to have a gun or emergency food. In fact, it's part of the Patriot Act. If you have more than 2 weeks of food, it's actually considered a federal crime and you can be in prison for 1 year. And if you have a one-year sentence in a state or federal... This is in the Patriot Act 1, by the way. I've read the copies. You can be interred in one of 80 camps, even outside the United States, anywhere in the world, tortured and killed at the behest of the government without any habeas corpus, just like the National Defense Authorization Act. So we have total tyranny now. This is not partial tyranny. We are literally in the jowls of the beast, and the beast just has chewed us a bit, but he hasn't swallowed us yet. But believe me, the tongue is pushing back, and we're heading to the back of the throat.
And that's not all. I mean, when you talk about World War Z, I just watched 12 Monkeys with Brad Pitt. You know that movie from 1999?
Yeah.
Right.
And it talks about the same thing. A bioweapon being released. Bruce Willis again being sent into the past in order to prevent the bio attack from happening. And the whole world is basically underground because of the biological release, and all the animals are on top of the surface of the planet. So, yeah,
Bruce Willis belongs to a secret sacred order of the Roman Catholic Church that's satanic. Do you know that?
Well, now we know.
Yeah. Yeah, and you can know that Brad Pitt, who's, by the way, related to the Queen, and his wife is a UN special representative, have got special places in the order. Welcome back, and and any other news about space, weather, earthquakes, volcanoes, or these events like this Comet Lemon, I would predict if it travels close enough that it's going to have some effect on geotectonic and gravitonic effects. Because what it'll do is it'll perturb the torsion field of the planet, which holds literally the crust of the Earth and the mantle and the magma, and it'll change the plasma physics of our planet. So I would expect to see some unusual geotectonic events occur on the planet, unusual climate events, and if it passes close enough to the sun, I'd expect to see a superstorm occur on the sun.
Well, it probably will, and in fact, when Pan-STARRS passed by, there was a super storm on the sun, but it was on the back side. But that sunspot is now rotated to the front side, and they're looking for it to let off with a flare. Actually,
right, so it's like a guy spinning with a shotgun, and he's got a blindfold on a platform, and that spinning takes, what, 29 days for the sun to rotate? I think something
27.
Like that. 27. And so the sun's spinning, and this platform rotates around, so the guy with the shotgun, every so many seconds, he's firing off a blast, because consider him a hot sunspot. And if he happens to be aimed even with a certain angle of impact on the Earth's magnetosphere and the three-level Van Allen radiation belt and perturbs it, we'll get a major transfer of energy that can cause a geotectonic, earthquake, volcanism event, or literally trigger off major superstorms on the planet, because the perturbation of the ionosphere moves all the air currents in the upper atmosphere and literally changes the climate of the planet. In fact, most people are aware of this, but the transoceanic high-altitude movement of water in these areas that are like 100,000 feet is, I think, 200 or 300 times the amount of water that flows in on the Amazon River. That's in the upper atmosphere, tiny water droplets. And it's traveling at around 300 miles an hour. That's pretty significant, isn't it?
That is very significant. And people have been asking me, they said, well, we know that there's an uplift under the Canary Islands of El Hierro. They've measured that, and we know there's one over at just south of India by Banda Aceh, and that's where that 9.0 earthquake occurred. And we know that there's an uplift now. They've mapped a big uplift the size of San Diego County just off the Cocos Place on the East Pacific Rise. So it's under the ocean, but the ocean floor is rising. And people ask me, well, you know, it looks like it's rising around the Earth. Well, we have to remember that when we had the big earthquakes, the 9.0 in Banda Aceh, and when we had the big one up in Japan, the 9, and when we had the 8.6, whatever it was, in Chile, the Earth actually got a little smaller in diameter. It actually, you know, it caused just a little bit of change in the diameter of the Earth. And so what's happening is that when you put magma under pressure, it heats up, and when it heats up, it expands. And so now we're seeing magma rising. And, you know, the Earth wants to be stable. You know, the Earth wants to rotate around its axes, around its,
right.
Well, whatever you call it, the moment of inertia. And it's not, because of different earthquakes and volcanic and even meteors that or asteroids that fell into, the big one that fell into the Pacific Ocean how many eons ago. That one still has...
Right, in other words, the center of the... In other words, the Earth is like a pudding with large masses of objects that are of different densities, so that it can't rotate around its actual, what would you consider its central axis, if the mass was all of the same homogeneous density and mass.
Well, not only that, the Earth has a bulge in the South Pacific Ocean.
Right.
From that
right, so,
asteroid that fell into the South Pacific Ocean.
So here's the bottom line. The bottom line is the globalists feel they're conservers of the civilization. Their overlords are satanic transdimensional entities that came from the belt of Orion many thousands of years ago and have interfered with human culture. I call them the sons and daughters of clay and iron, literally transdimensional entities. That's why they believe they're basically the lineal rulers of Earth, because they have a certain amount of genetics and spiritual genetics that is literally transdimensional serpentine entities.
Do you know when the best time to see them is?
Yeah.
What time of the year is the best time to see those creatures? Do you know?
Spring or fall?
At perihelion or at winter solstice.
Yeah, perihelion, which is the feast of Lupercalia, the feast of Nimbus, the time when the Earth is basically the farthest away in terms of its the northern hemisphere away from the sun, yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, we have been told that, oh, well, we adopted Christmas to a pagan holiday because they were anxious that the days start getting longer, and so they celebrated when the days started getting longer. Well, yeah, but there were other things going on, because the ancients, they had a lot of time to observe. They weren't sitting in front of their iPads or anything, and they knew that there were spiritual beings that could be seen at that time.
Well, one of the things that I'll just open this up a bit too is once in a while I'll open up some of the 90% I know they don't talk about much. Probably about 20% of children to maybe 30% are very intuitive, and they often will have what's called pattern nocturnos and night terrors because they can see these entities, especially when they sleep. And during the day, that's why you'll see little children say they have a friend. They're not psychotic and they're not losing their mind. Mm-hmm. Any individual who's gone through a near-death experience, a very high percentage of them, once they open up the what's called the astral gate and they've gone through a near-death experience, they forever will see or have apparitions or have an increased intensity. Some that already have a tendency toward being able to see that after that traumatic experience have considerably more. Now, I died at birth and at 8.5. So I always see into the other realm, always. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I don't have to go into it. I don't need to take ayahuasca or do these other things, and I'm not psychotic. It's just like having second sight, you know, like that movie, you know, I see dead people. Well, the fact is that there's a transdimensional world that's very real, and the problem is that the population of Earth are victims of it because they don't understand the malevolent intelligence of the evil that's truly trying to consume mankind. They don't believe it. They think that their little Pollyanna world is just whatever they can see with their visual eyes, and the problem is there's much more to the universe than what they assume. Much more to the universe. And that's why when you hear, you know, Jesuits talking about the idea that Jesus was a star child, which I talked about in the last hour, which is evil, or that we need to be evangelized by transdimensional entities from other worlds in the cosmos, not. You know, this is pretty damned evil. This is another gospel. This is a doctrine of devils. This is the final deception. It says, because you, O Earth, you know, people of Earth, love not the truth, I shall send you a strong delusion so that literally, believing the strong delusion, you'll be destroyed. So he said, even if the elect could be deceived, in other words, people that look like they're real good Christians, real nice people, and real spiritual, they'll believe this delusion, and they'll be indignant over the fact that you don't believe it.
Well, yeah, and so people who have this spiritual pathway open, the Irish call it thin places, and apparently the Irish, are, you know, their brains are arranged a little bit differently because they are very primitive people. They weren't Anglo-Saxon. They were the people that were originally on the British Isles before the Romans came over, and then before the Goths, I mean, before the Anglos came over from France. So they're a more primitive people, and their brains are, I don't mean primitive in the sense that
they're more in tune with the spiritual realities, which is why when you hear all the little stories about leprechauns and all the other things.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and so, you know, their brains are arranged a little bit differently, and they have... a lot of times, I found being in a Presbyterian church, a lot of those people are do have this second sight ability.
Right. Now, when I say this, there's a scientific thing. In fact, if you actually go to Les EMF, you can actually get equipment that can measure the electromagnetic spectra of these entities. You can actually buy that equipment physically and actually test it. That's equipment. Of course, human beings are far more sensitive than any equipment. And what we are really is we're a much more advanced being than what people assume. Human beings are pretty amazing. We're made in the image of the Creator God of the universe. We're not just like an animal. Back in a moment with much more with Alexander Bachman, Ann Morrison. Amazing things. Amazing days. Welcome back, and the map of the world after the major earth changes that I've been shown supernaturally is where North America will be thrust by a disjunction between the lithosphere, the crust, and the earth by 1,200 miles south, which will bring Siberia and Russia and China 1,200 miles north, and places like Israel and will move around 900 to 800 miles northward from where it is now. And Moscow and these other places will be inside the Arctic Circle. That's where it's going. And what people need to understand, or very close to the Arctic Circle, you're going to see major climate shifts occurring on the Earth before that happens as birth pangs. But it says that every island and every continent shall be moved out of its place, and that everyone means the entire destruction of the Earth. So we're not talking about a pole flip where the north and south pole flip, but it could be magnetically. They can magnetically flip, but you're talking about a disjunction where the crust of the Earth moves. If you actually look at the ancient geology, I think it's 8 million years ago, Alaska was on the equator. Alaska was on the equator. So,
well, you know, it ties in with all these ancient studies of ancient civilizations, antediluvian civilizations, where they talk about pyramid systems in Alaska. Right. What was just discovered, and, you know, it confirms this, is Easter Island. It turns out that the Rapa Nui, you know, the big heads that are there, these big head statues, turns out somebody got the idea to start, excavating around them. It turns out they're huge, massive statues. It's not just the heads. They're enormous statues.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Oh, that's really clever. That's really funny. So they actually saw the head, and they thought it was just a head statue, and there's actually a whole statue below that. That's funny.
Oh, enormous. I mean, they're just massive megalithical objects, and they even have...
I believe a reproductive
organ of sorts hanging out. You know, it's really, really
weird. Now, the other thing is, I believe in Standale's thesis about the enlargement of planets. The best way, I watched the show last night about glass blowing. The Earth at the time of the flood was roughly 40% smaller than the current Earth.
Right, I believe that, because people live longer.
And that means people live longer. There was two atmospheres of pressure on the Earth, and that the oxygen was around 35 to 40%.
And
in fact, the magnetic field was strong enough that they could support creatures. For example, the dinosaurs, which lived millions of years ago, could not have been supported with a current magnetic field. So even if you could, quote, genetically engineer to make the dinosaurs, their bones would not be able to hold them together because the magnetic field is not strong enough to support their bone structure.
And a T-Rex wouldn't be able, for example, today to run at the speed that it was supposed to run if it were alive today. The Earth would have...
It's a warm-blooded... By the way, it's not
smaller.
Not only that, it's also, most people don't realize that the dinosaurs were warm-blooded. They were not cold-blooded like snakes. And that these warm-blooded creatures use a lot of oxygen up, and without the high oxygen concentration, they would literally be kind of laying down, and of course they'd starve to death because they can be, their predators, they are eating other organisms. So the whole world was completely different. And in fact, the magnetic field, just from the time of Babylon to current, has dropped by more than 40 times, just since Babylon. So, in 3,000 years, the magnetic field has dropped that much.
They're worried about that because they've measured it on Mars, and they say that that's one reason Mars doesn't have an atmosphere. It's because they don't have a magnetosphere.
Right. Without a magnetosphere, you don't have an ozone layer. We don't have an ozone layer, you don't have protection against cosmic background radiation and all those other things, and eventually it destroys the planet. Yeah. It's a major factor. But I don't think that'll stop because the Earth is a nuclear reactor, and what we're about to see is the field will drop and then it comes back. And you can see that in the zebra markings on the bottom of the ocean. They used to take these magnetometers to actually measure the ocean floor because they're looking for U-boats. And they discovered these zebra stripes of magnetic flux field changes on the bottom of the ocean. And it was because the magma comes out of the mid-oceanic ridge and then moves out, and every so many thousand years there's new stripes because the magnetic field changes. And they realize that, oh my gosh, this is changing all the time.
Yeah.
It's always changing direction.
Yep.
So the crystals and the magnetite were always changing direction, which is interesting because, of course, that's how the Vikings navigated with the lodestone and with their wheels that you could see on the movie, on the series Vikings, where they look at the sun and look with their little wheel and tell them if they were flying west or, you know, going west or not in their boats. Where all of this is going is this. We're about to see the two popes, the two-headed beast popes, the false prophet in the White House, and the beast dictator in Russia, who now controls nuclear weapons and the armaments for China and all the Muslim countries are tied directly to Russia, who will soon be making a deal after the Cyprus thing to literally be incorporated in a new, larger Europe. So Russia will be totally incorporated in this new empire. This new empire of Russia, combined with Europe, will be the most powerful empire on the planet. That's why they refer in the Bible to the beast dictator. And by the way, the mystics in Russia knew this 500 years ago during Alexander the Great. They knew that there was prophecies that Russia would eventually be the ruling, in a sense, power on Earth. Now, the beast system will be worshipped by the mark of the beast, which will come out of America, and the ultimate, most advanced weapons are still controlled by America. But in terms of actual power of control of oil and resources and integration into Europe and control of Islam and China, it's Russia. And people need to realize that. That's why when we see all these things happening and the Russians try to play this game, or the Chinese, that bad North Korea, why are you doing this? The Russians and the Chinese are working directly with North Korea to make sure they created this situation. Why are they doing this? Because they play both sides, because the dialectic serves their purpose, doesn't it?
Well, yeah. I mean, you know, up above in the highest echelon, all of them are friends. They all sleep together, and they all conduct business as usual on behalf of their Lord Satan. So that's just
right.
The main crux of the matter. I mean, it's just about the remnant, which is the elect, which are the all Christian people, are the true elect, and they are the true people of Israel.
The best way to describe the believers is we're the body. It says body of Christ, which means basically human beings are the actual spiritual children of the creator of the universe, which means when you become a child or daughter of the daughter or son of the Most High God, you are literally have the authority of the creator of the universe. You're literally the bride, the wife of God. And your children, your biological children, worship the Creator, and His Spirit, when it fuses with the spiritual souls of those children, they literally go from being mortal souls to immortal souls. They go literally because the Spirit, the will of the Most High God, enters them, and they become a new creature. So the reason why Satan is so determined to get rid of them is because he's trying to literally abort not just the physical bodies, but the spiritual bodies of all of God's children on this planet. And when we hear this kind of garbage coming out of the Jesuits and the Catholic Church, it's because they want to send another gospel, literally a doctrine of devils, to tell us that we need to have cosmic evangelists to tell us the truth about who Jesus Christ is. Now, you know, there's things that I know that I won't say yet. At someday I will say them, but I can tell you what people often believe is the true gospel has only been partially taught. Much of the true gospel that Jesus taught has been suppressed, hasn't it?
It has been suppressed, and it has been distorted. These dispensationalists like L.A. Marsouli and the rest of the gang are just spitting out lies, telling the people that to prepare for a great tribulation of 7 years when it's been proven that this is a fraud, and it happened in the 1830s. There is no rapture coming, okay? Okay.
Oh, yeah, so there's no rapture.
People must understand that. And
well, I don't know about the 7 years not existing, because I believe that it will start with the Feast of Tabernacles. But the real issue is there's no rapture. I had a lady back in 1999 after I spoke in Dallas to about 750 people, and she says, at the end of the talk, she came up, she said, "Dr. Tingle, I don't know, what about the rapture?" I said, "Well, I'll tell you what, you're in Dallas, and if there's a thermonuclear weapon from Russia or China comes down and hits your city with, say, 50 megatons, and all of a sudden you're vaporized and you're up in the clouds and you're meeting Jesus, that's the rapture." And she said, "Oh, really long, right?" She got it. I said, "Look, there's no such thing as a rapture. This is foolishness. This is evil. In fact, it came out of some teenage girl in Scotland and was picked up by Darby and went on to become incorporated into the one of the Bible commentaries and one of the Bibles and literally became a branch of Christianity. It's all hogwash. It's all, by the way, Masonic. Just like the millennialism that they're going to have be a millennium. Jesus said right through the prophet Daniel that the statue that cut out without the stone cut out without human hands strikes the statue of Daniel's prophecy of King Nebuchadnezzar on the toes and destroys it, and it never will rise again, which means when this world order system is gone, you'll never see a resurgence of satanic power on this planet again. It'll be gone forever.
That's
we have a great hope, and that is our God.
And
what we have to know is that
context and everything.
Right. What we're going to do is God is a God of order and simplicity, not disorder. It's real simple. Yeshua HaMashiach, the Father in the flesh, is coming back soon. And without God, there's nothing that we can do beyond doing minor preparations. As I say, it's just a temporary Band-Aid. Without an intervention by the Creator God, we're all toast. We're done. And pray for repentance so the people beforehand don't just die physically, but they don't die spiritually. Pray for America. Pray for our leaders that God brings judgment, because when you pray for your leaders, He'll cut off their